praise his holy name. Thank you, Jesus. And I might just want you to go. But I just appreciate him. Thank you for sparing my life. Thank you, Jesus. Thank God for my new health. Praise his holy name. I know that my faith is coming back, and I know that it's going to be a day that I can look back and just give him praise for this day. For me again off of medication. Praise his holy name. But I just want to thank the Lord for just keeping me. Thank you, His Holy Name. You know, the enemy hit and attacked my body with my sugar again, and I had to go back on medication. Praise His Holy Name. But God is good. And I still thank Him for each and every day. Praise His Holy Name. But you know, Jesus is getting us back to a place to believe Him and nothing else but Him. Praise His Holy Name. And I hadn't got to that place, but I'm working on it. Praise His Holy Name. Thank you, Jesus. But I just want to testify about, for about 2 months now, I've been on this medication. And ever since I've been on the medication makes me sick. And I don't know how to describe it because it's just a sick, you know, just sickness. It's a sickness, you know? And it just work with you, just mess you up. And it works with my stomach, most of all. It's messing with my stomach so bad. And I have to get in the bed or something. I don't have strength to just stay up. I just have to hit the bed. Not because I want to be in the bed. I can't help it. Praise his holy name. But you know, I went back to the doctor. He wanted me back, and I went back. And he told me to start taking 2 pills instead of the 1 I was taking. And I did what he said. I had to go back again. And I was telling him, the second time I went back, I was telling him how the 2 pills would make me sick, so he said, take 1. Then when I went back last week, he said, get back on the 2 pills, and they just makes me sick. Praise his holy name. But nevertheless, I tried to do what he said do. And the medicine just had me just sick, like I said. And I was, when I left church Saturday for last, I was so sick till I didn't recognize the symptoms that I needed to eat. My sugar was dropping too low. Because I was already sick, but nevertheless, I went out, I think Tuesday, I had to take my sister. I take my sister to the doctor. I came back and I had things I need to try to do so I wouldn't have to be out both days. So I was trying to get my chores done, and I went into Kroger's. And while I was in there, I kept feeling so bad. And I even began to feel worse, and I didn't understand exactly where I was feeling so bad. And I kept on trying to push myself. Then all of a sudden, you know, my sugar just got so low until I just began to just shake. Then I recognized what was happening. And I heard him as I was going into the back of the store called Joshua's name. And I looked up and I saw Joshua, but at that time I wasn't feeling that. I hadn't got to that point. And I just continued to go on. But you know, when I made my way back up to the front of the store to give me something to eat so I could feel better when I recognized what was happening, I just, you know, I thought about Joshua. I said, well, I wish he could just come up to the front of the store. If he'd come up to the front of the store, I'd get him to touch and agree with me, you know, to pray so I'd feel better. But nevertheless, I went on and I ate. And that's the most horrible feeling, sisters, when your sugar dropped too low.
Oh, yeah.
You don't feel no pain, but you're so sick. You're so sick at that point. And I went on and I ate something. I sat there about 15 or 20 minutes. I began to come back to myself, and I got on up when I felt better. Finished doing my shopping and went on home. And when I got home, I don't know exactly what I did, but anyway, I didn't even feel like coming to service Tuesday night, but I just fought my way on anyway, because I said, well, I know, you know, I need to be there, and I don't like laying out of church. But nevertheless, I'm going to try to make it short. Praise his holy name. I came on out Tuesday night, and I was sitting under my stomach, was acting up so bad, and it was just about time for Brother Austin to come out, and the enemy, I says, I'm going to go back and get him to pray with me. And the devil began to say, no, I'm Bob, he's finna get ready to come out. You know, he just began to talk to my mind, and after a while, I just got up and went on back there. And I asked him to pray with me because my stomach was acting up so bad. I was so sick at that point. And he did. He touched and he grieved and he prayed. And I came on back out and I sit down. Hallelujah. I sit down, and just as he was getting ready to take the service, before he got a chance to read his text, God had gave me a completely deliverance. You know, I tell you immediately, you know? And I haven't had that sickness in my stomach. I didn't have it that morning. After it left that time, it went on away Sunday. The next 2 days, it wasn't there. But I knew the medication was, something was wrong with the medication. So I went on back to the doctor Thursday. And when I went back there, the doctor wasn't in, but he has a nurse practitioner to stand in for him. And I really didn't want him to do nothing but change that medication. So she looked at me, and I was telling her about what was going on. And she looked at me, and she said, we can try to find something. Trying to make the story short, but he told me he could give me something else, but my insurance wouldn't cover it. So anyway, by him not being that same thing, I believe it's the same stuff that he was talking about, She gave me some of it. And she gave me some samples, and she also wrote a scripture called it in. But nevertheless, ever since, when I told her my symptoms were, she looked at me and said, from the any time, anywhere else, don't let anybody else give you that medication, so you're allergic. Hallelujah. You're allergic to that medication, you know? And I just thank God for keeping me for those 2 months. Now, you know, when people take medicine sometimes, you know, they call medicine. I know that sickness was delivered. That, you know, we brought off to pray for me. I believe that because I wasn't sick the next 2 days, but I know I need to come off that medication. And you know what the doctors had done told me? So we won't even talk about that because your insurance won't pay for that medication. But she went on and she did this, you know, and I thank the Lord for her doing this. You know, and I feel so much better. It feels good not to get up and be sick in the morning time. It feels good to go out and, you know, walk throughout the day not be sick and feeling all bad. So I thank God for that. But I want that one medication for the whole month was $175. I said, you put that back. You know, I won't deal with that right now. So I'm going to talk with the doctor when I go back, you know. But I just thank God for just stepping in there and delivering me, not letting the enemy take a hold to my body. So, you know, I got something to praise God for. Yeah.
Just for believing in him. They will make us just, amen. He can't deny us when we believe in him. You know, I'm just thankful, Lord, amen, for giving me back my prayer life, amen.
Praise God,
amen.
Praise
my prayer life, amen.
Ah.
And now I thank God.
Praise
God. You know, Jesus doing something for my heart.
All right.
Amen, he's doing something for my mind. And I thank for that. Yeah. Amen, I thank for, you know, just turning my heart around.
Praise
God. Before I was telling myself, Lord, just give me a total U-turn in my life. Glory, hallelujah. Oh, glory, hallelujah. U-turn in my life. I said, Lord, I just want to be that sanctified woman that you called me to be. And now I'm there, amen. You know, I was there to get my hair fixed, and this traffic police officer was there, amen. He was showing some pictures of how kids be hurt in accident and everything. I don't want to go all through it, amen. And you know, I went back and it kind of troubled me a little bit. You know, it would trouble you. And my spirit was troubled, man. I said, Lord, some of them, they just don't know how to pray. And some people just not going to listen. Some people just don't want to come. But some people just don't know. Amen. And you know, I was praying. I was telling Brother Fred, I said, well, you know what, Lord? I said, through your help, I'll stand in the gap and pray with them. Amen. I'll pray with the people. Amen. You know, somebody got to stand in the gap.
Somebody
and pray for the people. Amen. Just like somebody pray for us. Brother Fred, I said, you know what, somebody prayed for us, and man, we was out in sin, amen, somebody.
That's right.
And you know, I just thank the Lord, amen, how this, when I was little growing up, how this sanctified ladies always come to the neighborhood, amen. She always sings songs, everything, and just sing all the time. And most of the time, I'd be outside playing, amen, she picked me out of all the kids, and she'd say, come on, go get her the cheer over the neighborhood, amen, and she'd sit us on the porch, and she'd sit down, get the Bible, amen, and read the Bible to them, and I didn't know anything about the Bible, and I really didn't want to be together the kids. I mean, I wanted to play, amen. And every time I saw that, I wanted to play, you know. But I thank God, you know, she always tell me, she said, you know what, Amy? She said, the Lord's going to use you one day. Amen. She kept that going in my head. The Lord's going to use you one day. And, you know, I truly thank God for that old woman. You know, and you appreciate, amen, most of all, Jesus. When you thank God when the Lord lay on people hard, amen. But people that really love the Lord, and people that really can get hold of God for you, amen. I just appreciate that, amen. I just thank God, you know. over you and pray for you, amen. It's a blessing. I was telling someone, amen, I said, you know, I said when I was, can't remember who were, I said, but you know what? I said when I was a semi, I had went to the church and it was House of Front. I said, I was saved and I was demon possessed, amen, very demon possessed, and I thank God. But it was just an old little woman there, an old little woman, the name of my mom, though y'all, some of y'all might know her. And then, you know, I walked in, amen, and lady began to pray for me, man. She prayed for me just hours and hours. By the time she got through praying for me, her clothes wet, and you just can squeeze water out of her clothes, amen. But you know what? Thank God for that, amen. I thank the Lord that somebody, amen, saw a son, amen, that needed to be saved, amen, and got down and prayed with me to the Lord, gave me my deliverance, amen. And that's exactly what I'm praying, I'm doing, amen, just praying with people that sick and come, people get their deliverance, because God is calling for those kind of people now, amen. Seeking out for those kind of people. He looking for those kind of people that will pray, amen. You know, sometimes you have to sacrifice and pray. A lot of time I was sacrificing and praying, and I thank God, you know, and one day this week, my mind was just troubling, I couldn't sleep, and you know, just troubling, my spirit was troubling, and just troubling, I tell you, and every time went by, and maybe a couple of nights later, I began to pray and cry, and I felt so good, amen, so good, since all that, just crying, I was talking to the Lord, I felt so much better, and I said, Lord, that's all I need to do, just get down and pray, just talk to you, amen, and you know, when the enemy get on your trail, and when Satan thinks he's on your back, all you gotta do is just talk to Jesus, all you gotta do is just talk to him, amen, and when you begin to talk to him, Lord, the devil got to go, amen, but you all pray my strength, Lord, and I love y'all, pray for me, amen.
Oh, is salvation. You know, I thank God for the word. You know, we overcome by the word of God.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And I thank God for blessing me and keeping me and delivering me and healing my body. You know, every day of the pain go through my body, I tell the devil, you are down, you lay in the way. You know, and I know God said by his stripes we are healed. You know, if we believe in the word of God and stand on the word of God, you know, we deliver saints. All we have to do is just trust in Jesus.
That's right.
Jesus is right here for us.
Yeah.
You know, it's just that Holy Ghost power.
Oh,
when you start to praise the Lord and you know, and praise God and giving, and you know, all your sickness and pain come to the Lord. You know, saints, when you get through praying, all that pain gone.
Yeah.
And that ain't Jesus. Who is it?
Man.
Because the devil, he can't do it.
Right.
Devil come and put pain
on me.
God come to take it away.
Yes.
And you know, all we have to do is believe in Jesus.
Yes.
And say, I believe in God with all my heart and soul. I believe in Jesus and I believe the word. You know, I stand on the word of God. And I know that if I don't stand on the word of God, I can't make it safe. I stand on the word. I believe what the word says. God said, and you know, you can be crazy for Jesus.
Man.
And you can be stupid for the devil.
Right.
But I'm crazy for Jesus Christ.
Man, that's all right.
I want more of the Lord in my life.
Man.
The saints, I won't take nothing for Jesus.
Man.
Because Jesus is my doctor. He is everything
Man.
To me. And you know, I just love the Lord. I love to praise the Lord. And I would not go back to serve the devil.
Man.
I don't care how the devil fight me, saints. I'm going to push on.
Right.
I'm pushing on. What the end is going to be.
Yes.
And I want, you know, meet Jesus. And I thank you, know, and I talk to people, and they don't realize, you know, that it's a heaven and a hell.
Right.
You know, you're going to one. Either
right.
You're going to heaven or you're going to hell.
Man.
And I don't want to go to hell.
Right.
And I repent every day and ask the Lord, forgive me for my sin.
Man.
Because we ain't perfect. Like, we're going to do something in between that day. We're going to get angry. We're going to say something. We're going to have no business. But God told us to keep on repenting the heart at all times. You know, repent for your sin. Search your heart. You know, and I search my heart every day because the job that I got, you know, it is. You know, you can get angry or you can pray for the people because they don't understand. They don't know because they don't know Jesus.
Amen.
But I got something with down inside of me, you know, to keep me from getting angry.
Amen.
And I look and I said, Lord, forgive them. They don't know. And you know, they don't know you. And you know, and I go on and I pray. And I'm going to say this, you know, my manager, she like, you know how, you know, she be just saying things. The, you know, the devil say things upset you.
Man.
And you know, he keep saying things until you say something out the way. And then you have to end up going every pit. You know, saying, I don't know that, you know, a lot of y'all have been this. But anyway, you know, Sister Cap, Miss Cap kept on, you know, talking. And so what I did, I said something I had no business but. Really then, right then, the Lord had me to go back. You know, that's a bad business. God had me to turn around right then and go back and repent. Even though, you know, she didn't understand that. But, you know, it's in my heart. I felt real guilty. And I felt like somebody had whooped me, you know, and had got a whooping or something. So I just turned around and I went back and I repented and all of that, you know, burden that went off of me. But you know, it just being saved and had a Lord.
Amen.
You can't do that to sinner people.
Right.
You know, you got to separate yourself from the sinner people.
Amen.
And you know, the Lord had me to know that. So I went back and I asked her to forgive me. And I felt better about that. And I also told her, I said, I am not like y'all. I'm different.
Amen.
I can't sit around you all and talk and joke and laugh and talk about people.
Right.
And you know, God is not in that.
Amen.
And that's what they do. And so I separate. The Lord says, separate yourself from that.
Yeah.
And so during the day, lunch hour, I separate myself. They ask me, Miss Kimber, why are you not sitting around us? And I said, you know, I be like concentrate praying. Come, I don't care for the TV, you know, watching TV, joke, talk about people, because I know that that's not God.
Amen.
You know, you can get away from the Lord doing that every day, every day. But people, they need prayer.
Amen.
Pray God's people to pray.
Praise the Lord. We have one more testimony. Praise God.
Praise the Lord. Praise God.
Praise God.
Glad to be here. Yeah. Praise God. Every time I come to church, I feel better and better. Praise God. Feel so good this morning. Praise God. Look like everything coming back to me, you know. And I appreciate the prayer of the righteous. Praise God. I feel like getting out there dancing.
Go ahead.
Praise God. I just feel better and better. I was telling Sister Diana, I talked to her this morning. Come out, the devil fighting, and you know, I said, the devil fighting us all.
Amen.
I said, the devil fighting me too, but you gotta come on to church. Amen. I said, Lord, I don't feel me feel like coming. I said, well, I come on anyway. Amen. I said, when I get there, I feel better. Amen. And I said, I thank the Lord for your deliverance. Amen. And praise God. They said, since all you sound like yourself, I feel like my old self.
Amen.
Praise God, too. I really am. I appreciate the prayer of the righteous very much. And I'm coming on, praise God. I said, Lord, I love this place, this. I'd rather be, I ain't got nowhere else to go.
Right.
You got to be
right.
Love, but can
that's
I go?
Right. Right.
You got the word to eternal life,
amen.
Praise God. And I tell Brother Austin, you know something, Brother Austin? I said, I'm glad to be alive. I got to be. Because I could have been a goner.
That's right.
Praise God, because the devil had a death mark on me. Praise God, but Jesus said, come and give me life.
Yes.
Praise God. And I appreciate his healing. Appreciate the life he's given me. Praise God. I appreciate the love of God in my heart. I appreciate the love of God in your heart. I appreciate all the people here. Y'all, they make me feel so good. These people love you. I ain't talking about playing like nothing. Because you know why? Because you know when you get sick, praise God, that's where the love of God really comes. Praise God. Everybody early in the college, she ain't feeling good herself. But she called checking on me to see how I'm doing. Praise God. I appreciate everybody. Praise God. I appreciate people cooking for me. Praise God. Miss Karen cooking for me. Praise God. Sister Duran, for old everybody. Sister Amy coming by seeing me. Praise God. I just appreciate everybody. Appreciate my dad. I appreciate all of you. Y'all have been so good to me, spoiling me. Already with lazy. You make me lazy on my ass. Well, I could tell the truth. Y'all just making me lazy, but you're making me know that you love me. Praise God. I didn't know you really love me. I mean that you did, but you showed it. Praise God. And brother, don't say nothing about my brother Durant. Praise God. Just saying about me. Praise God. Encouraging me. Appreciate that song. That song. Come my body do belong to God. Praise God. Appreciate my husband encouraging me. Cooking for me. He just boarded me. He said, I'd be right in the room and tell me, chap, come do something. For me, baby, right here. Well, I appreciate it. Encourage me. Telling me I can make it, you know. You need somebody to tell you you can make it. Appreciate Brother Paul taking over. I appreciate it, though. We just went good together, you know. But I appreciate him talking about, this is awesome. I've been having to sing a song for me. I appreciate it. I really do appreciate people in general. I do. I appreciate everybody. Most really, Sister Roll, come see about me. Praise God. Appreciate Brother. Brother Theo being back with us. Just appreciate my brother, Brother Robert. Praise God. Appreciate all of y'all. Appreciate Charlie. Praise God. Y'all coming in. Praise God. I appreciate everybody. Y'all just pray my strength in the Lord. Appreciate my sister coming. Praise God. I appreciate, you know, sometimes you get the running service and stuff. And I appreciate Brother Paul, you know, praise God, how you make me feel, praise God. Come on, since I'm seeing. I think that is so nice. I do appreciate that. Praise God. Now I'm going to turn the hand.
We're going to go ahead and stand on our feet. Thank you, Lord. Give the Lord a good hand. Thank you, Lord. Happy Father's Day to everybody again. Say it earlier. We just appreciate all of them. Praise God. Somebody got a Father's Day present on. Maybe they do it, maybe they don't. But a friend showed it to me. But appreciate the Lord. And everybody just reach out to the Lord and receive our pastor. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. We gathered in your name and thank you for that. Thanks for giving us a name, Lord, that we can believe in, that we can trust in. A name of authority and power. Thank you, Lord. We're not hopeless, but we have hope. Not living in a world where there is no hope, there's hope in you, Lord. I thank you. God, it's what we have to go through. It's hope in you. We appreciate you for that. Guide us today, Lord. Direct the mind. I'm asking you to watch over us, though we're just sheep. Lord, we're just little people, God. We need you. See after us. Watch over us, Lord. Pray us, Lord, like you do a little baby. In Jesus' name. Sometimes we don't know where we go. Don't know what we do. Lord, don't know where we're at, Lord. So watch over us. Keep us, Lord, as we sometimes we may venture out into danger. And God, be there to watch over us and turn us around and shield us from it. Move the danger out of the way, Lord, to redirect our path. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Lamb of God, they got a saying, you said, how I look, Lord God, you know what's going on. And I'm asking you, Jesus, to watch over these that gather into this place and love ones. I pray, Lord, as we live in this old world, the enemy's out there. He's going as a roaring lion, seeking whom he can devour. And we asking you, Jesus, to be mindful of us and help us, Lord, and the enemy will come upon us like a flood. God, you said the Spirit of the Lord will raise up a stand against him. Raise up a stand against this enemy that's coming up on your people like a flood, Lord. That Sister Brown, Sister Helen, daughter, God, she got this tumor in the brain. It's malignant, God. Move it, crush it. Dry it up, God, by your Spirit and power. In the name of Jesus the Christ of God, be it so, Lord, today. And I thank you, we give you praise. In Jesus' name. Give him a hand and praise when you may receive it. Send down your rain. Send down your rain. Yeah.
Thank you.
establish the reign of Christ. Thank you, God. troubles is the troubles of mind, the troubles of spirit. But I am the Lord God who watches over you. And I know your mind, and I know your spirit. And I know the thing that easily affects you. My God, did I not speak, so I am come down to deliver you. For the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. And he has anointed me to open up the prison doors, to cover the sights to the blind. Even as a small matter with you, I, God, stand on authority. I, God, utter my voice from the throne. Even I sent forth my deliverance unto the children of Israel. I, God, shall make it all well with you. Let your eyes behold my salvation. See, is it I not God that speaks to you? Is it I not God that will deliver you, that will help you, that will sustain you in the things that trouble you? The Lord speaks it to be so. Hey, so give him a praise, somebody. many know we got a friend in Jesus? You know, Jesus told us himself, I have not called you. I'm not calling you a servant no more. I'm calling you a friend. Thank you, Jesus. Believe God ain't for that. The Lord is not for that. The word of his
Lord.
Even if you think you may be in control of your life, but you're not in control of your life. Even the thing that's going on, the Lord permitted. He's waiting. He got a time set. He had even written it down on his agenda. Even as the same others, he had a time set. He had written down, he had purpose in his heart that he was going to bring into pass, even the children of Israel. Out of 400 some years in darkness, the Lord had a time set. But God has not forgotten the word that he was spoken unto you. I, God, my Lord, shall raise you up. I have not forgotten even the pleasures that our pleasures and joys. I'm going to give you a pleasure in me. I'm going to sanctify your spirit. I, God's going to do it. You don't have to do it. I, the Lord, is going to bring it to this place, and it's going to be a place in me. It's going to be a place of reality. It's not going to be a church place, but it's going to be a place in my spirit, says God. Holy Lamb of God, be it so unto her today, God. And I thank you, Lord. I know you have not forgotten. I decree it to come to pass. Let not your heart be troubled. Not be weary. Be not afraid of my word that I speak unto you. Let it not be a fearful thing, for I, God, is in control of this. You don't have to worry. When I bring you into this place, your heart is going to be pleased. Fear not that it ain't it's something that you won't enjoy, something that you're not like. Worry not. Let not your heart, let me have it. Let me be in control of this thing. I, God, know how to work it all out. Holy Kisaka. Basiliese, Seki Bikos Babaka. In the name of Jesus, be it so, God. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Sometimes we get a little fearful, especially when we y'all. We think this may not be God. You know, we think this may not be God. Let's just get back and let the Lord take care of it. Don't try to force nothing. Don't force nothing. Let God take care of it. Don't go out there and try to, God don't want to go out there and try to be something that we ain't, to let God take care of it. You know? Let God see the matter. Especially young folks. Sometimes they be afraid. They don't like to get worried like that because they ain't ready to give up yet. God is in control. Let God take care of it. The Lord is going to take care of it. Thank you, Jesus. And some of your church folks may see y'all may be doing this, some of you gotta be doing it. Don't worry about it.
Right
there. Let God be in control of this. When I tell folks this is a mix of God behind
you. That's right.
And I roam the streets out all night long and stand out all night. Come home the next day up in the day, sometimes you know, just doing what I want to do. But God had control of my life.
Yeah.
Yeah. Then God got ready, Sister Charlie called.
Yeah.
I told him when I was a little boy, don't be a preacher. I didn't know. Don't milk me if they said I said it. But Brother Fred, I drank on my job. I would get back in the hole and I would drink, man. We would sneak liquor on the job. We'd go hide and drink it, you know. I was in control of everything. I thought, Sister Ruth God was in control. And when he got ready, you know when he got ready to pull you out of the nightclub, he pulled you out of it. You didn't have no say so in the matter. God, get ready, and you're pleased today, ain't you?
I'm pleased, very happy.
And nobody love the world like I love it. I mean, I love the world. Are you listening to me? I love partying. I love it. Then we Brother Banks. Then we Mr. Banks. And that's my dad-in-law. We did a little boogaloo together. Mr. Banks can do that for a penis, but I didn't know he could do it, but I got a dead room late, but he's out of the bed. Look at y'all. I beat me, man. He'll keep me down. That's right. I'm telling off on you, brother, man. That's like it. But we love the world. But when Jesus got ready,
I don't want no more.
I don't want no more of you. The Lord brought me out of it. Is this doing? I'm pleased, Sister Banks. I didn't come out before I got ready. I didn't come out before God got ready. I didn't come out. Jesus brought me out. When he brought me out, he fixed my mind. And then he prepared my mind, Brother Clark, to be saved. He took the world away from me. He didn't take the remembrance of it. He just took it. He gave me a greater desire. To fight. Even now, the world come to us, Brother Fred, and tax us not, but God had given us a greater desire. To hold on to Jesus. The world still come to us. But thank God, the Lord had given us that greater desire.
Greater desire to have.
Hold on to Him. Greater desire to resist Him. God's going to bless your whole family. Amen. Believe that? God's going to bless your whole family. I said, God's going to bless your whole family.
Glory. Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Master. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Can't believe Jesus here. Yes. Lord. I appreciate Sister Dawn. Appreciate John Brown. She can't sing too good. She can't sing too good. We appreciate them coming. Thank you, Lord. Appreciate what God really doing for, I tell you. You got somebody been being with you and stuff like that, man. Just ain't there, you know. Isn't there? I'm going to ask, are you lonesome? She said, no, I'm just, sometimes she be sitting back there by herself. I said, I go back and peep and look at her, you know. I said, you lonesome? She said, no, I'm fine. Let me hear you. That's something, she'll break something, do something. Man, let me know that. Appreciate it. Come on, give him a hand, Brady. Appreciate it. Appreciate the Lord. Appreciate your prayers. Appreciate Sister Naomi being with us today. Appreciate your prayers. Keep them prayers a rolling, man. How many gonna keep them prayers a rolling? Keep them prayers a rolling. Look, now, I just had forgot about it until I said about the prayer. I'm back on begin. I don't want to start having maybe a Bible study. I think it's the 20th of July. 20th of July, I think. This is our birthday. 20th of July. You know, that'll be Friday. You know, 20th of June. Tomorrow? I mean, next week? Oh, it's going to be June. Oh, okay. It's coming Friday. About 8 o'clock. We're going to have prayer first. Probably start with the Bible. This is a Bible discussion. It ain't a preaching service. It's a Bible discussion. It's going to be open. Anybody you may want to ask questions or find out something, just get in there and just sit and listen. Ask questions. Sometimes it's just a good job. So they're going to start at this Friday. I'm talking about, I'll be for prayer. I may not be for the Bible study, then I may sometimes. It ain't somewhere you just come and sit and listen to somebody. It's somewhere you come and everybody participate. You know? You can ask questions. It's about stuff. Maybe something you want to add. Something you've been up. Just have your input in. So I think they're going to tell all of you. I think prayer is going to start about 7. They'll pray about 7, 8. And they're going to start to. Bible discussion. You may want to write something down sometimes. You want to ask the person about it. And if they don't have an answer, if we don't have it, we can look it up. We'll find it, you know. Have it for your next time. Praise the Lord. Give him a hand, praise, will you? We appreciate it. Appreciate the Lord. We're going to let you give it and let you go. Appreciate God. We ministered the word today, but that's just all right. Ever seen an offering. I want to ask you to bless the Lord today. In the offering. Those of you who have an offering to give, we appreciate it. Bless the Lord. Thank God for the sunshine.
Amen.
Thank God. we saw about three accidents coming over. Man, ran down here out of the sea and people just driving like food. And this, appreciate the dog pressing her way on. Now she had a toothache. And though she's on me. Appreciate her pressing her way on in the way. Appreciate the Lord. Ask you to bless the Lord at this time. And we gonna let you. Y'all brought stuff to the sandwich. We always had one out, man. You know, every family had one, called to keep the door closed. And we had one out, man. You know, I ain't gonna call the name, but he's got a black suit on. He's here today. Hey, down there, did y'all leave it for you yesterday? Did y'all go there? Before you leave, if you get the rush off, I might let you go there. Let that little air today. Brother Friend, Brother Parks. Y'all about to want to be like this call right now. Listen, y'all be on guard on the Tuesday night, right? Don't now let folks know, but sometimes it be the spur of the moment. Sometimes it be the spur of the moment. And I may call you to take the service. But Mark, y'all be,
yes, sir.
I said, y'all be ready on a Tuesday night sometime. It'll be, maybe it'll spread them on. Maybe I'll back on. I'll take the service. And sometime out on that be the side. Okay, thanks, man. Be ready. Sister Bruce, y'all can be ready sometime. I know, my boy. Thank you, Sister Bruce. My friend, thank you. And, just be ready. Sister Bruce, be good, you get your mess together.
Yeah, it would.
Sister Rose.
That's right.
Nah, I get you. Cory, man, you got to. You gotta get to be no Superman, no Superwoman.
You gotta be yourself.
Be yourself. It'll be good for you. Thank you, Jesus. Listen, we appreciate your prayers, okay? And continue. Y'all see what prayers are doing, Sister Austin.
Amen.
I tell you, she's just up getting an appetite back. I had to go yesterday and get a hamburger. Went to McDonald's, went to a burger walk, they said that they. I think they brought there, though. After they put the station out, they put them seasoning and the salt. They had one of them. She ate some greens and something. And so I had to cook some peas and potatoes. She warms on them, ate that, they ate greens. I get about an hour so late, she said, I'm going to get something else to eat. That's right. I can eat a hamburger. I have no first of all, I can't eat a hamburger. And everybody, y'all just continue to pray, will you? Put your hand as I ask the Lord.
Lord,
bless this. The Father. in Jesus' name. Thank you for this offer today. And we appreciate you for these that pressed their way, Lord. It's raining heavy this morning. They pray. Thank you for the crystal, my granddaughter, back there in Kansas. In Jesus' name, Lord, we thank you. We ask you to turn this to give us 100-fold. Bless it in Jesus' name and multiply. Amen. Thank you for it. Thank you, Lord. Give me a hand, Bridget. Just 1 minute, y'all. We're going to pray.
Okay, come on, Chris. Go let your eyes. Brother, me right up to come on, Chris. We're going to pray for her.
And, while we pray, we're going to pray for our daughter, Lucy. Father, in the name of Jesus, God help, I pray, rebuke every devouring spirit, every hindering spirit, God, every devil binding in Jesus. God, open up for us. Let your mercy, God, let it be manifested unto her today. I'm asking you. Lord, you see this enemy coming up on him. And I'm asking you to turn him away. Loose it. God, I pray by the Holy Ghost. He said, God, that you come to deliver us and help us. And I pray this prayer of faith today that you turn the enemy away. Turn his old spirit, God, that put him in bad. Break this hold of the enemy. And I pray, God, a blessing upon their house. Pray, God, that you get in there. Sometimes, God, you go in there first. And you do. Sometimes, God, you don't wait on us to do stuff. You go and bless us and help us first. And Lord, this is what I'm asking you today. Be a sword unto them. And then let them recognize it, God. Let them give you praise and give you time. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray, God, for every situation and from every desire, bring it to pass. Let it happen. God, let them happen as I ask you today. Jesus, there may be one thing that's really in her heart, God, that she so desires right now. And I'm asking you, God, as a sign, let it come to pass by the Spirit of God. I decree it to be so. And I thank you.
Bless us, Lord. I pray in Jesus' name. Keep us sustained by the Holy Ghost. Bless us, God. I pray in Jesus' name. Help us, God. In Jesus' name. Bless us, God. Okay, you won't feel me. You do. Father, in Jesus' name, you want to, but the devil won't let us. God bless us to be obedient in Jesus' name. Bless him, God.
Come on, give him a hand praise for you. Thank you. Stand to your feet. Appreciate you. Thank God. Brother Parks, come on. Listen, aside if you want to be in this Bible discussion, be here about 8 o'clock. If you want to get into prayer, be here about 7. You may enjoy.
Lord, we thank you again today, Lord. Thank you for the service, Lord. Thank you for how you reached out and touched, Lord, the needy, God. We ask you, God, to just be with us, Lord, the rest of